Hello everyone, welcome back to my channel, Stay Tuned Laura. Sorry, I hit my Christmas tree. I'm Laura, obviously. Alright guys, I want to welcome you back to another video. And like I've stated in my previous video, it's obviously already like the 2nd of December. And with that in mind, I did want to kick off, you know, like the holiday spirit with this video. So if you haven't felt the love already in the last video, right? So on that note, I wanted to go ahead and show you guys some art that I did last year for Christmas for my brother, my sister, and my dad. So unfortunately, I don't have, you know, like the physical copies, like the artworks, you know what I mean? Like my actual drawings. But I do have pictures of the completed works, so I'm gonna go ahead and show you guys that. But before I do so, I want to go ahead and just say that the reason why I decided to do artwork last year for my family was because at the time I didn't really have like an abundance of like money. So I was like, you know what, I still want to be able to give something to my family without it like, you know, costing a whole arm and a leg, right? Even though I suppose technically it did cost me quite a bit of money. But still, I mean, these were some of my favorite gifts that like I've ever done for, well, anyone. And I really think that my family appreciated what I did for them. So the reason why I say is that it still costed me. The reason why it cost me a decent amount of money anyway is because I went ahead and got them printed out for them and I got it framed. So yeah, I will not keep you in suspense any longer. Let's go ahead and take a look at the finished products. And these were done in Photoshop. Alright guys, there you guys have it. What do you guys think? Do you like the colors? Is there anyone or anything that you've recognized in these, you know, artworks? You better have. Alright, so let me go ahead and tell you what gift was for who. You know what I mean? So Travis Scott, if you didn't recognize him, I don't know how you wouldn't, right? For Travis Scott, I did give that to my little brother. So the reason why I gave him that is because he would always go on and on and on about, oh, Laura, like Travis Scott, oh, Laura, do you know who he is? Oh, Laura, like he's gonna have a baby with Kylie Jenner or something like that, right? I don't know. He would just give me gossip and he would try to convince me so freaking hard to listen to his music. And his music isn't bad, admittedly. It's not too bad. I'm not super into like rap or genre, like similar genre like that. I like some of it but not all of it. But I digress. Yeah, I drew my brother Travis Scott because he would just go on and on, like I said. And he would even try to convince my mom, like, hey mom, like I heard him, like, mom, come on, he's coming to Texas. He's like, let's go see them. I know you like Travis Scott too. And my mom was just like, yes, Junior, yes. Like, you know, she would just like pump him up and stuff because apparently he got my mom into his music taste. So yeah, I'm happy that they can share like a close bond like that. But anyway, yes, though, how I did Travis Scott for my brother was that I actually found a cool picture of him. You know, hopefully this isn't some weird, like, copyright infringement, because that totally wasn't, like, what I meant to do, but yeah, if I did, I am so sorry. Anyway, I found this cool picture of him, and I was like, you know what, this seems cool, like, this seems like, you know, it would be, like, poster worthy, you know? So I got the picture, and I kind of just did this all in one layer, surprisingly. Usually I do several layers. Like, I usually have at least 10 layers for anything that I like color in Photoshop or in Krita, right? But this one I just like kind of like freehanded it on just one layer. So I put it like, I moved the photo like to like the left, and then I made sure I had some room like on my right side, which is why, you know, he's centered on the, like, on the right. And I was just kind of like looking at the picture, and then I was you know, like digitally painting him, right? So yeah, I just kind of did that. I kept blending and adding all these cool colors to try to mix the colors together, right? And honestly, at first I thought it wasn't gonna turn out good, and I believe, if I'm like recalling correctly, I think I actually like scrapped like two first attempts, and then I just started to go with the technique that I was just describing, you know, like just kind of like mixing colors together and blending and what have you, right? I decided to not go with line work, basically, is what I'm trying to say. So yeah, I did that, and I had a really good time, actually, and I really love the way it came out. And the only thing I didn't do was draw his tattoos, because to be honest, I could not like decipher what I was looking at, like on his skin. So I was like, you know what, it's fine. Junior, my brother, would like it anyway. So yeah, I finished that up, and I could not wait for him to see it. And thankfully, yeah, like, he loved it. And funny thing, because when I actually went to go print it out at Walmart, I already paid for it online and everything. All I had to do was pick it up, right? And I actually had to get in a huge annoying fight with like three employees, because they did not want to give him to me, like the my own like drawing of like Travis Scott, right? And I showed them my the pictures that I showed you in the slideshow for Travis Scott, and they were still like, nope, that looks like something professional. I'm like, okay, well, thank you, first of all. Sorry, Simon is here. So yeah, first of all, thank you for the compliment, but I still need my drawing, right? I already paid for it. So yeah, after much dispute, I actually like ended up haggling my way into getting the Travis Scott poster that I did for my brother, and I kind of just made it much more like valuable to him. He already liked the story behind it. He really liked that I had to fight for his Christmas present. And apparently he went on Snapchat after I left, and he was just sending his friends all the Travis Scott, like the photos he has of him, right, that I gave him. And all his friends liked it, which made me feel good, obviously. And they were apparently big fans of Travis Scott as well, so yay. Alright, so that wraps things up about, you know, who Travis Scott belongs to, like, when I was doing these Christmas presents. So now let's move on to Alfalfa. I know Alfalfa is so weird, right? Like, he looks a little bit strange now that I look at him, like, after like a year, and I'm like, I totally see all the things I could have done differently. The only things that I still enjoy about Alfalfa is that I loved skin. He has very, like, you know, you've seen the movie, right? Little Rascals. I mean, Alfalfa has very clear, very, like, almost translucent pale skin, you know? So I tried my hardest to get to nail that color, but what I would have done differently is I would have definitely done the hair differently. I would have done maybe like the heart differently as well, and I definitely would have changed his eyes, because that's what made him look kind of creepy. But I still think it's cute, and that gift was actually for my sister. She's a big fan of like old movies and old shows and stuff. She likes vintage things, so I was like, you know what? Oh, and not to mention that Little Rascals was one of her favorite movies growing up, so I was like, you know what? Let me go ahead and do this Alfalfa for her. And actually, Alfalfa wasn't like specifically made for her, if I'm being honest. It was actually used, like I drew this picture of Alfalfa for the Inktober challenge of 2018, but I was like, you know what? Or 2019, I apologize. Or I don't remember. 2018, 2019, one of those. But anyway, I digress. I was like, you know what? Hey, that'll make a really cool poster if I just finish it up, right? So yeah, there's a story of Alfalfa. Well, the Alfalfa poster that I made for my sister, right? All right, and when it came to the Juggernaut, I know that one looks just so like bright and like crisp, and I'm really happy with the Juggernaut. That was actually the gift from my father. He, you know, got me into like almost all the things that I love today. Like, you know, he got me into comics, he got me into heroes like X-Men and Silver Surfer, Spider-Man, whatever, like all these heroes, Batman, right? Like you name it. He got me into Marvel and DC. So yeah, like since I was a little girl and we used to watch like some cartoons together and stuff. So, and he would constantly talk about his favorite character from X-Men, which was the Juggernaut. And we all know Juggernaut is really awesome, he's really powerful. And I was like, you know what, he's been asking me for like years, like, hey, Lore, they call me Lore. He's like, why haven't you made me a Juggernaut, like, drawing yet? And I'm just like, oh, like, you know, at the time, I'm not gonna lie, I didn't wanna do it. I didn't wanna do it, and you know what, honestly, I'm glad that I waited, like, you know, all these extra years, because I feel like it would not have come out as awesome as it did, you know, this time that, like, you know, I did Juggernaut. And my dad really loved it, you know, I printed it out for him, no issues with the printing on that. And yeah, I mean, I got it framed as well, and apparently he wants to put it in his classroom, but yeah, well now he's not because of obviously like COVID and stuff, right? But he was also very, very afraid that it was gonna get stolen, which I agree on that. I wouldn't feel comfortable leaving like something I worked so hard on, you know, somewhere and then like someone to just steal it, you know what I mean? But yeah, I believe out of the three, my favorite like present that I drew, between, you know, like Travis Scott, Alfalfa, and the Juggernaut, I'm very, very stuck between Travis Scott and the Juggernaut, but I want to say Juggernaut just because I really do like X-Men, and I'm just, you know, not to pat myself on the back or anything, right? But I just really loved how it came out. It was so bright, it's so like just in your face, you know? And yeah, that has to be my favorite. But Travis Scott is like right there, like, you know, just right there. But yeah, there you guys have it. What do you guys think? Did you have a favorite of the three? You already know my favorite, and like I said, like recently, like literally 3 seconds ago, I'm stuck. It's a very close race between Travis Scott and Juggernaut. So yeah, let me know if you guys have a favorite of the three in the comments section. I will reply to you guys. It might be a little bit late, but I will get to you. You guys already know I'm a super busy lady, so yeah. Alright guys, well I'm gonna go ahead and wrap things up now. I want to thank you, like always, for staying tuned. Thank you so much for your support. Thank you very much for your encouragement. And I genuinely hope that you guys are having as much fun watching my videos as I am having fun making them for you. Alright guys, well I'll see you next time. Bye.